doing his life in the right way, and he's willing to come back, and he'll take on anybody. He doesn't duck anybody.
And for Gotti the third, this is the perfect fight. Everybody knows in the fight game, it's about the backstory. It's about the hype. There has never been a backstory like this ever in boxing, in MMA, in any combat sport. You guys know Bob Carson. He's a walking encyclopedia of combat sports and of MMA. Bob, has there ever been in the history of sports a fight with this kind of a background?
No, I've never seen it. I've been around the sport of mixed martial arts since 1999. I've competed, I've covered it since 2006. I've never seen anything like it, which is why I'm down here. I'm down here because I'm genuinely intrigued as someone who covers the sport and as a fan myself.
I'll tell you guys, I managed Phil Baroni, I managed UFC Hall of Famer Stefan Bonner. Everybody knows Dan the Beast Severn. I've been around for a long time. I worked for Bellator in marketing during Bjorn Rebney's tenure. We only time ever that we beat UFC head-to-head in the ratings was when I put the Bonner-Tito Ortiz fight together. I know how to make money in the game. Derek Panza, you're holding this kid back. John Gotti III is not even scratching the surface of what he could do, and there is no other fight in the game he could take that has anywhere near this kind of backstory.
Is there a timeline for this fight? What has to happen to make this fight happen?
Well, you know, I've got promoters who are already interested. What needs to happen is they need to accept. That's the bottom line.
John Gotti Jr., who you want to fight, I'm assuming he's relatively the same age as you in shape. Do you have any idea his background? Does he have a boxing background? He seems like he's in pretty good shape.
Well, he could.